Thank you. See? You'll see that little run right there when the light hits it. And I never realized until I painted the car black that it actually has a lot of, I want to say, like road dent marks, like the one you're seeing right there. You know, tried sanding that down as much as I could, but it didn't come out as flat, I guess I want to say. I do need to use Bondo, you know, before doing something like this. And I mean, those are really the steps. But I mean, this is just the first coat. It's meant to be squint. I'm gonna continue taping up some of those areas where the trims are, and I'm gonna go ahead and keep painting since it's Sunday and there's a lot of daylight. But it's coming out really great. This side over here came out even better, honestly. Doesn't have as many runs as the other side, and looks more glossy and everything, you know. Once I sand it down with that super fine grit paper, it's gonna look more like this. It's gonna look more flat. It's gonna remove that gloss and remove a lot of the runs. It's gonna end up coming out a lot better. So let's get to it before we run out of time. It's looking good though. Pretty content. What's good, guys? It's been a long few months. Hasn't really been that long since I posted, but it's been a long time, honestly, for me since I worked on the car. I've done a lot, as you can probably see. The entire car is black, just, well, besides that, and besides the windshield wiper area bracket right here. And what I'm going to be talking about today is the header, nose, whatever you want to call it, until I can get some proper funds to buy myself a new one. I'm going to be using the old one. I've kind of already dinged it and hammered it to put it back into place, and this is pretty much the gap that I'm looking at. It's a little off center here, and there's a slight gap here, but it was a lot worse, more pushed in towards that way, and I managed to hammer it into place and ding this back into place to make it look a little bit more leveled, and it's not too bad. So what I'm gonna do for today is I'm going to sand it all the way down, ding it a little bit more, and then from there what we're gonna do is we're gonna paint it and we're gonna keep going from there. So alrighty, so I finished grinding it down in some areas. There is a lot of rust, as you can probably see. You could just focus. Some rust holes and around the corresponding, corresponding areas. And I also noticed that there used to be Bondo. So you'll see the Bondo in some of the spots right here. It's basically this block right here. It's kind of cracked all the way through. I think welding it back into place is probably going to be a lot better than using this Bondo just to cover it up, because there's a lot of rust towards the inside. But I've sanded a vast majority of it down, and I mean, this is pretty much the finished result. So because it had Bondo, I started off with the grinder just to get some of those areas, and then after that I got the sander and I sanded it down just to make sure that everything's properly flat. And then from there, I'm going to put a primer that's going to seal in those areas. And after it's sealed in the areas, well, first I'm going to hammer it down. So we get this little hammer right here, and I'm going to just flatten, go on the back of some of the surfaces, just make sure that they're flat and put them in a good spot. And then from there, I'll add the primer to it. For the primer, I'm going to use just this engine enamel primer. I mean, you could use a different type of primer, probably the same type that's for the Rust-Oleum. But afterwards, I'll go in with whatever's left in this Rust-Oleum can. It's pretty much a full can, and the area should be covered. I'll put it back in place to where it is, and it'll look nice, bright, and even. So let's keep doing that. This video. Thank you guys for watching, and stay tuned next time. Please like and subscribe.